Now we can see a new world coming into view. A world in which there is the very real prospect of a new world order.
The new world order does not mean surrendering our national sovereignty or forfeiting our interests.
Bullshit!
Standing up to all enemies of our nation, foreign and domestic, we are the Bearded Patriots.
What is going on, everybody? It is I, Bad Billy, from Twin Falls, Idaho, host of Outlaw Radio and founder of the Bearded Patriots. Before I get started with this not-so-special edition of the Bearded Patriots Video Chronicles, I want to remind you to check out my websites. There's the Outlaw Radio official website. That is www.outlawradioabs.com. That's right. Outlaw Radio, AlphaBravoSierra.com, and of course, the Bearded Patriots official website. That is www.TheBeardedPatriots.com. That's right, TheBeardedPatriots.com. And while you're at it, don't forget to check out our affiliates. Of course, the Caravan to Midnight store. That's right, we got the Nucleo Boost that was just recently released, and something... You consume this and you're going to feel a lot better, let me tell you. There's also the most important one, I think, is my Patriot Supply. So if there's an unplanned emergency, or should I say when there's an unplanned emergency, you have a supply of food with a shelf life of 25 years. Yes, get yourself some buckets of food with a shelf life of 25 years for when the next unplanned emergency hits, or if Klaus Schwab really kicks through his agenda and everybody has to eat bugs, you have something to fall back on. There's also MyPillow, Mike Lindell. Yes, whether it's MyPillow.com or MyStore.com, use the promo code OUTLAW and save yourself up to 66%, even more during specials. Yes, indeed. And of course, there is also Tactical Brotherhood, We the People Holsters, the newest one, Patriot Cigar Company. With Patriot Cigars, use promo code OUTLAW to get up to 15% off some good cigars, and also enroll in Red Pill University. Yes, all links in the description of this video. No matter what platform you're watching it on, the links are in the description. So like I said, this is a not-so-special edition of the Bearded Patriots Video Chronicles. And why do I say that? Well, let me give you a video clip here that's about 6 minutes long that will explain it all. Here you go.
Well, well, well. We haven't been here in a long time, have we? But we're here to address the cocksucker faggot Billy Painter problem out there, who obviously wants attention from us. Well, Billy, you got it. You want my attention, motherfucker? You got it right now. And I'm going to tell you just like it is, motherfucker. First of all, everybody, Billy Painter is nothing but a fucking liar, a pathetic loser with no talent and has nothing going for him. He's just an old, well, he looks like 100 years old with that filthy, disgusting beard that he hasn't washed in like years. And he claims that he's leader of the Bearded Patriots. Well, what is that, Billy? A radical group that's anti-government? Maybe your group should be investigated by the FBI, right? Maybe they should be investigated by ATF, right? Maybe they should be investigated by local law enforcement, right? Because, Billy, you're fucking with the wrong guy. You better stop your bullshit. But I know you won't because you're mentally retarded and you're a very sick person and you're a very jealous person. And This guy, Billy, is one of the most jealous people I have ever met in my entire life. Obsessed with us. Creeping around like the stalker that he is. Going to my face crap page. Harassing my friends. Bothering my friends. Threatening my friends. Making false stories about us. It's pathetic. Here, just let me do this for a second. Hold on one second. Is that a good picture? No, I'm going to adjust it here. Let's see if that does it. Okay. That should give us a little bit more stability. So Billy's at it again, going on my face crap page, making a burner account, what it's called, which is a false account, disguising himself, hiding, making videos that he doesn't want me to see. This guy is a pathetic loser. I tell you what, Billy. You want some of this? Come on, motherfucker. You want some of me? I promise you. When a person is as angry as I am, and I totally hate your guts, you don't want to face me. One-on-one, face-to-face. Because I put the challenge out there before. I told the coordinates where to meet me. He's scared. He want to meet me in Central Park. No. You're the bitch. You're the one that's sucking my dick for fucking milk money. I call the shots. And you chickened out. Because let's face it. Billy, you're a fucking chicken shit hiding behind the social media, being a coward that you are. And let me tell you something. I've already made a complaint against you to the FBI. Okay? Don't worry what I said to them. But you should be getting a call in the near future. And tell everyone that you got a call from the FBI, Billy. Don't forget to do that, because you did that last time. You know? You were almost like proud of it, weren't you, that you spoke to the FBI. Okay? So, expect a call. But like I said, Billy, you want to end this back and forth stuff, this creepy shit? Come see me. Come see me fucking face to face, motherfucker. Okay? Come see me. Because you will regret it. Because Billy Painter just talks a lot of bullshit. He's got diarrhea of the mouth. I know now that Billy's full of shit. That he's a punk. That he's a pussy. That he's scared of his own shadow. People who are scared like him talk the most gaga, because he's got diarrhea of the mouth. Billy, I know you're full of shit. And I'm calling you out right now. I'm calling you out, motherfucker. Come to fucking New York. Tell me the day, the time, and where you'll be. And I'll show up. And I will show up. And let's see what kind of a real man you think you are. Because you're not. You're a pussy. You're a punk. I know that. Didn't know that the very first time I talked to you. After a few times, I sized you up. I said, this guy's a pussy, a punk, and a coward. And he ain't going to do nothing. He ain't going to show up. He ain't going to fight no one. As a matter of fact, he's going to hide under his fucking so-called wife's skirt. Because who would marry a guy with no toenails? That's what was said on the podcast, you know. That you were trying to fool around with some girl, harass some girl. I know you sexually harassed other women at the fair, from what the podcast said. I'm just quoting the podcast. And you were trying to get this girl, and she found out you had no toenails. Which is disgusting, by the way. What do you do, pick them with your mouth? Like that? Oh, Billy, 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 Billy! You know, all you gotta do is show up. That's all you gotta do. You want me so bad? Put up a shut up, punk.
All right. Oh, my goodness. I mean, I know I shouldn't really be giving this guy any attention, but just two things that prompted me to do this video, because he actually did a string of videos where he's talking about me. So, first off, Asgard Radio. I had no idea that he was brought onto that platform, and if I did know, I would have contacted Jim Harwood immediately, because I used to be a DJ on Asgard Radio from 2017 to 2020. I was running a show on Asgard Radio called The Indie Asylum. I had a pretty good listener base there, too. But Asgard Radio is a fantastic station for local and unsigned independent rock. Yes, and that was what my show was based on, is all independent musicians from not just within the U.S., but all around the world. I was, they'd send me their music and I'd give them some airtime. Yes. So, but unfortunately, when COVID hit, in 2020, I was working for Cox Communications, spelled COX, by the way. And anybody who lives in areas of Florida, or you live in Las Vegas, or parts of Southern California, or elsewhere, Georgia is one of them. That's a big internet and cable provider. And I was working customer service for them. Then COVID hit. And I was forced to work from home. And not only was I forced to work from home, massive overtime came in at the beginning of COVID. And I did not have time to do the Indie Asylum. So I basically was forced to hang it up with Asgard Radio at that time. Yes. So that's the story of my history with Asgard Radio. I'm still get along well with Jim Harwood now. Of course, like I said, had I known Joe was going to go over there before he even started, I would have contacted Jim right away and let him know what kind of a piece of trash, what kind of a racist, bigoted piece of trash Joe from New York is. And then, of course, the whole ordeal about my toenails, which is brought up. Good Lord. I had my toenails surgically removed. Not all 10 toes, just my two big toes on each foot were surgically removed 20 years ago due to a condition of where they were growing in a curve, and I was constantly getting treated for ingrown toenails, so I just figured, there was no way around it. I was going to go the rest of my life having to deal with that every now and then, so I had... In order to get rid of the problem permanently, I had to have my toenails on my big toes permanently removed. Not that that's even relevant, but, and the girl that she didn't like the sound of it. Her name was Roxy. And I'll tell you what, Roxy and I get along just fine. But of course, Fresno, that old fart, big time liar right there, he likes to run with that, but it didn't really put a damper on Roxy and I's friendship. It did put a damper on her attraction to me after I told her that, but it didn't put a damper on our friendship. So what? That's okay. I mean, I was living in Las Vegas. She was living in Ohio. I'm not going to do a long distance relationship anyway. So no skin off my ass there. But moving right along, the things that I really take personal from about Joe, I mean, first off, anybody who follows me and knows that they know that I'm not a communist, they know I'm a true patriot. But at the same time, I expose real racism, not a bunch of fake racism and all that, this woke movement now wanting to get rid of the word field because they think it's something racist, or some idiots that want to get rid of power hoses because in in places like San Francisco and Seattle, where homeless people are defecating in the streets. And, you know, they got to clean them up, and they started using power hoses. But the use of power hoses was offending people because they were used during the 1960s civil rights movements and things like that. So, you know, I mean, that's woke bullshit, you know, saying bringing out a power hose, that's not real racism. Using the term field is not real racism. But Crazy Joe from New York blaring the N-word, calling me N-lover, which I have a recording of him doing this. That is racism. That is real bigotry. And he displays it when he opens his mouth, plain and simple. And but what I really take personal now, because I'm talking a lot of stuff, is the things he's saying about my sister, which are really personal. So, you know, and he can take what I'm saying from this video and he can twist it up and he can make up more stories. But let me tell you something when it comes to my sister. Okay, first off, the beard was originally grown for my dad, because my dad had a great big beard. My dad was killed in a work-related accident when I was 10 years old. Only 3 days after my 10th birthday, my dad was killed in a work-related accident. All right? I mean, and things like this happen to a lot of people. All right? But what was not known for 36 years or over 40 years is that my dad had a daughter that... you know, he hooked up with a woman shortly before he hooked up with my mother. And yes, he got her pregnant. But they had a falling out and lost contact 100%. She never told my dad that she was pregnant with his child. And so this lady... who, I mean, it's 40-some years later, you know, she thinks this one man in her life was her father, and then he reveals that he's not, and so she's trying to seek the truth, and she goes to her mother and say, who are you with? What's his name? I need to know who my dad was. And so she got a name, which happened to be my dad, Donald Eugene Painter. And luckily, I made a Facebook page in memory of my dad. So this lady and her daughter did a search and found my dad's profile. And in turn, they found me and said, you know, we may be related. The daughter told me that her mother may be my half-sister. So I arrange a meeting, because they only live about 130 miles from me. They came out to meet me, and at first when they hit me up too, I almost told them to go to hell, because I thought it was a scam at first, until I saw the pictures, saw the resemblance to my dad and the rest of my family, and I said, oh no, we got to figure something out here. So, you know, she looks too much like a member of my family. So we met, and I worked, like I said, working for Cox Communications. This is all in 2020, right in the height of COVID, shortly after Asgard Radio, that I had to quit Asgard Radio. And I took all the overtime I could. I said when there was more overtime than what I was already assigned, I took it so I could get a very expensive DNA test done, which cost me, it was about a $500 DNA test that my sister and I had to take. And, you know, we got quick results too because of the high price. So, yeah, we got the mouth swab. I get a call from the lab a few days later, and I find out that, yes, the test came back positive for siblings. And it was one of the happiest moments of my life because my dad had been gone for 36 years at that time. And something I thought I completely lost 36 years ago. I know I could never fully get back, but when that test came back positive for siblings, I felt like I got a small piece of that back, and I'll take it. And it I tell you, it was probably the happiest moment of my adult life. And for Joe to call her all kinds of horrible names just because her boyfriend is a black man, I do take that very personal, because now hearing the story, if he has any kind of heart in that chest of his, because he doesn't have a brain in that head, he would understand why I take that personal and why he doesn't need to be talking that kind of shit. Oh, but he's some kind of Howard Stern shock jock, and he's going to say whatever. So what, he can take it whichever way he pleases, and he can still talk shit. He can talk shit about my dad, who's been gone for 38 years now. Yeah, as of this year. See, third, yeah, so 2022, October 2022, that makes 38 years. So it's going on 39 years now that he's been gone. So, yeah, they could, he can take it to any way he fucking well wishes, and talk all the shit he wants. So, and then if you keep calling me out to fight, Joe. And I'm going to tell you can say that all you want, that I don't have a wife, that I don't have a family. And none of that's true. If I was a single man, maybe I'd consider, with the kind of money I'm making, I'd consider taking a flight from Boise all the way to JFK and say, meet me in Central Park or something like that, and let's settle this once and for all. But Joe, come on. I'm not going out to New York because I'm afraid of you. I'm not going out to New York because that takes a lot of money. Now, if you want to pay my accommodations, you want to pay for my plane ticket, you want to pay for my hotels, and you want to pay for me to be able to eat while I'm out there, I'll take you up on the offer. If you want to pay for it, all of it, and you cover all expenses and sign a waiver, which includes you cover your own medical expenses when I kick the shit out of you, which I'm very confident that I would, then I'll be happy to accommodate you. Otherwise, the only other way I'm going to accommodate you is if you take a flight from JFK to out here and we settle it out here. In my neck of the woods. It doesn't matter to me, but I'm not coming to New York simply because I can't a fucking afford to, Joe. I got a family to take care of. I got rent to pay. I got food to put on the table. I got clothes to put on backs. I got a man's responsibility, something you would never fucking understand because let's face it, I don't think you have any children. You may have had a woman or two in your life, but you probably ran them out by the way you are. Because not only are you a racist, but you've also said very misogynistic things. Oh, yeah, like the manager of Voodoo Moonshine, what'd you call her? Just because Matt was going to interview her before you could, you called her a cunt? Yeah, that's misogynistic, Joe. Now then, let's talk about the Bearded Patriots, how you want to call the FBI on a radical group. Well, the Bearded Patriots, like I said, is something I just started this last May. Consists of me, Mike Miller out of Caldwell, Idaho, who ran for office but unfortunately lost in the primary. Then there's Jericho Green. You can find him on YouTube. He's a black conservative living in the depths of California, and a Navy veteran at that. And then, of course, there's Colonel Chris Wyatt, who spent the majority of his life, adult life, excuse me, in the military before he was forced to retire. Then there's Philip D. Blackman out of Texas. Just find him on YouTube as well, Philip D. Blackman and the Philip D. Blackman Show. There's John Grosvenor, one of the hosts of the Common Sense Conservatives in Nashua, New Hampshire. Of course, my good buddy, who doesn't have a full beard, but the icon, Stephen James, former law enforcement officer there and founder of AOW Productions. Then there's a rapper out of Texas, a Hispanic rapper by the name of Nightmare, N-I-T-E-M-A-R-E. And he's probably the only one of us in the Bearded Patriots that has a criminal record. But other than that, he's getting his life straight. Patriotsky of Patriot Soapbox and his show, the Patriotsky Tavern. Then there's another rapper, Stone Miller. And it's sad I can't remember where. I think he's out of Tennessee. And then the latest addition to the Bearded Patriots, Iceman of the Motor Cop Chronicles podcast. So there's only a few of us. None of us are up to any type of terroristic or any type of vigilante work or any type of violent network. So no, what are we at the Bearded Patriots for the most part? We are true patriots, true to the Constitution, and a lot of us are podcasters, whether or being in public office and things like that, or being activists. So you're going to call the FBI on that like we're some kind of group like Antifa? Is that what it is there, Joe? Because they ain't going to find nothing. Or does it frighten you that, a few of us are licensed to carry concealed? Yeah. Joe, you are a stupid, stupid man. I don't like normally coming up on here, especially on these channels, to bash people, but the way this man is now posing threats and posing threats against the Bearded Patriots and the crap he's talking. By the way, you didn't need to take that selfie in that one video. And you know what I'm talking about. And if you want to see any more of Joe's nonsense, I'll put the link. Also, the link in the description of this video to his YouTube channel. Yeah. So that's the whole threat against the Bearded Patriots is the main reason why I'm posting this video. But I decided to let it all out. From talking about my sister to my history with Asgard Radio to even my fucking toenails, which is irrelevant. All right. Oh, and by the way, that comment you made, talk about New Yorkers are the toughest, are the most intelligent. You don't have any fucking intelligence. And I'm sorry. New Yorkers, I do agree, are tough. I've seen some. I've met some. But I think people from the South, like Texas, they'll fucking clean the floor with you. And just to prove it also, there's a redneck hillbilly named Matt Lindland, who fought in the UFC. One of the guys he fought twice was the New York badass Phil Baroni. Now, and the first fight, Phil Baroni gave him a good fight, but he lost by a split decision. In the second fight, Phil Baroni got the shit kicked out of him by Matt Lindland. And then he fought Evan Tanner, a Texan, who he gave a damn good tough fight in the first time they fought. The second time they fought, fucking Evan Tanner just kicked the shit out of him. So, New Yorkers aren't all that you beef them up to be there, Jojo. They're not. They're nothing more than human being flesh and blood like the rest of us. Being from New York isn't like breathing that air like taking a steroid. No. Anyway, I have ranted enough. Like I said, check out my websites, Outlaw Radio, ABS, Alpha Bravo Sierra.com, and TheBeardedPatriots.com. I am Bad Billy, and I am fucking out of here.
Hi, it's the Big Voice Guy, the one who intros and promos the show you're listening to right now. Hi, my name is Jim Hunt. I voice for a growing list of internet and terrestrial radio stations, podcasts, and businesses. I'd love to spread the word about yours too, no matter if the message is serious or silly. Whether you want the delivery to be hard-hitting, voice of authority, or conversational, warm, and fuzzy. From fully produced station imaging and commercials
to custom phone system messages on hold and IVR prompts,
voiceovers for computer games to narrations for presentations, even post-production, audio editing, and audio cleanup services. Yeah, I do them too. I'm your guy. I do business as Jim Hunt Voiceovers and Audio Services. My rates are reasonable and negotiable because I love internet radio too. Visit my website, jimhuntvo.com. I'm Jim Hunt, at your service. Put my voice and audio production skills to work for you. Let's do this.
setting a course for the end of their own great nation. The ever-growing trend in this country is to judge people not by their individual character, but by their identity as a member of a specific group. No one has ever succeeded or failed in life as a result of their group affiliation. A person's success or failure is also not based on luck, but on the sum total of the decisions that they have made. Those who succeed do so through good work ethic and the wise use of their power to choose. The opposite is true of those who fail. The ideals of individual accountability and responsibility in the United States are dying every day. A gun cannot be responsible for a death, just as a shovel cannot be responsible for digging a ditch. Both are only tools and have no will of their own. Responsibility is an adjunct of conscious choice and is the price we pay for freedom. Freedom is also a tool. It's an essential tool that is needed by human beings if they are to prosper rather than to merely survive. Yet there are those who would rather trade their freedom for security. Some believe that it is the responsibility of government to provide freedom. In truth, we form government to ensure and protect the freedom that is already inherently ours.